welcome to Island Stats and this special sports award selection nomination night. We'll go through several terms and references that the committee will go through, but it's a chance for people to get an idea of who they want to nominate for the 2016 Athlete Male and Female of the Year, as well as Junior Male and Female Athlete of the Year. Joining me tonight is none other than the Director of Youth and Sport, Mr. Norbert Simons, and also committee member, none other than the ever popular Debbie Jones Hunter.
Hi, Earl. How are you?
Good evening to
Director
both of you.
Director Simons?
Good evening.
It's always a pleasure when we get together to discuss the sports awards.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
Well, Mr. Simons, the year is drawing to a close very fast, and the nomination forms are being sent out.
Yes, they are.
What is the deadline date for the 2016 Sports Awards nomination forms to be returned to Youth and Sport?
5 p.m. December 30th, 2016.
And has a date been set for the actual ceremony?
Yes, in fact, we've just confirmed the date. The ceremony will be held at the Fairmont Southampton Princess Resort Hotel on March 30th, 7 p.m. sharp.
Well, a lot of people will say we already know who that female athlete of the year is going to be. It's going to be who is going to be the male will be up in arms. We'll also have the challenge of the youth male and female athlete of the year. But what we want to do to this evening is go through some of the rules and regulations that we are governed by. Mm-hmm. We are all part of the committee. Mr. Simons is the person that votes, or his numbers count if there's a tie.
Correct.
But Debbie, you and I has got a challenge on our hands of
yes.
going through as much information as mm-hmm. possible, as well as Mr. Simons. But every vote counts.
Correct.
And we wanted to just break down the committee that we are governed under and the rules we're governed under. The Director of Youth and Sport is the chairman. The committee also consists of two representatives from sports media, press, radio, or television. Mm-hmm. Two representatives of from the Olympic sports, and that will be the Olympic Association.
The Olympic Association will appoint their representative.
Right. Mm-hmm. Okay, two individuals from non-Olympic sports, and then it's senior sports development officer who acts as the secretary.
Correct.
Mr. Simons? What are some of the things that you and this office from the Department of Youth and Sport look for from the general public to ensure that when it's presented to the committee, the correct information, enough information, and the required information is filled out for the committee to deliberate?
Yes, and that's exactly what we look for. And if we don't have enough information, we will always contact the person who nominated the individuals to seek more information. On occasion, we will go and do some research on our own mm-hmm. to augment the mm-hmm. information that's received. And the other thing that we do first is to ensure that the nominees are Bermudian. We
Correct.
Check with the Ministry of the Ministry of Immigration mm-hmm. or the Department of Immigration to confirm the status of the individuals concerned if they're Bermudian or not Bermudian.
Ms. Jen Santa, we sit around this particular table January for the last few years,
yeah.
and one of the things that we continuously come up with is lack of information.
Yes, that is always a challenge. We often say, and we say it every year, and we press upon the public, is that when you submit your information, as much as you can, and maybe retrieve from others, supply us with the needed information so we can make an informed decision. I just want to show that this by no means is no task that we take lightly, and our binder is actually this thick. And we are required to read all information and to come prepared that morning for discussion mm-hmm. and vote.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I might add that our staff put that binder together and put each category in place, and whatever information is provided, this is the same information that's provided to the committee. The committee is not allowed to bring any other information into the meeting except the information that we give them. On many occasions, we've sat down and asked questions about why it wasn't so-and-so nominated. But because the committee cannot make nominations on the day, there's nothing really stopping the committee, any committee member, from even nominating someone, but that information has to be in prior to when that bond is being put together.
Mm-hmm. And it's so true, Director. Yeah. We talk about it every meeting, mm-hmm. don't we?
Yes, we do.
And it's somewhat a bit disheartening when you see certain individuals' names without additional information.
Or any information at all.
Exactly. Yeah. And then one says, you know, well, they're worthy, why not? Well, you know, in that case, and that may be correct, but how can you put them, how can you give them an award based on no information?
Just a name on the sport.
Exactly. And so you don't want to be perceived that you're biased because you may know information. So we, you know, we really implore everyone who ever sends the, whoever nominates one, to please send the information in.
And the one thing I would like to stress as well, it's not a popularity contest. So you can get 1,000 people to write this person's name down in the sport, but it's not a popularity contest. It's what they've achieved in that calendar year. And that has to be stressed over and over and over again.
In that calendar year.
Yes.
Because sometimes the information may revert to prior years.
Mm-hmm. Well, now, there are categories that people can be nominated for, mm-hmm. things done years going by. But we'll get to that when we get through the special breakdown of what each category could be.
Mm-hmm.
We have what is considered the Achievement Awards. Mr. Hunter, can you just explain or break down some of the achievements?
Okay. The Achievement Awards. We actually have Outstanding Athletic Achievement, Special Achievement Award, and Achievement Award. Just to give you a little background, the Outstanding Athletic Achievement Award is presented to one male and female athlete annually at the Sports Awards. This athlete must have achieved during the award year an obvious level of maintained excellence in sport. Then you have the Special Achievement Award. This is an award presented to other athletes who have made a significant and sustained contribution to sport in a voluntary capacity. For example, sports medicine. And we actually gave out a maximum of 3 recipients will receive this award. And then it's the Achievement Award, which is presented to athletes who excel in national or international competition during the awards year. Very important,
that's right.
The awards year.
Yes.
And a maximum of 7 recipients may receive such awards. And that is based on the information that we receive. If we don't have a number of nominees, then we can give out more than what we have.
Right.
And so that is very important to understand.
So that takes care of 7, 3, and 2 is 12
yes.
recipients in just that block.
Just that block.
Just
yes.
that block.
So just that
7
block.
Awards could be presented in this one block to individuals who meet mm-hmm. the requirements of
yes.
an achievement award for 2016.
Yeah, and what I do want to say is that when we committee members get together and we deliberate and discuss, we do put major time in and a concerted effort,
mm-hmm.
and we do have a lively discussion around this table and an honest discussion.
Yes.
And I think that's important to know that there is a process that is to be followed, and we do take it seriously.
Yeah, I think what gets missed is the end result when people hear who the winners are and mm-hmm. sit back and say, well, how could that person be selected when this person, and you said it earlier, achieved so much more,
mm-hmm.
but that same person that's making the criticism didn't bother to write it down, send it in, do any of it.
Mm-hmm.
So we're imploring people that if you feel someone is worthy of any one of these awards for 2016,
mm-hmm.
then do what is required to get the information into the department,
right.
so that Deliberation Day, your person
yes.
is in front of us so we can deliberate on the possibility of that person receiving an award.
And then also, we may have a senior who mm-hmm. cannot bring the information into the office. You know, I'm sure that Director Simons will simply say that if they call in, then there'll be some sort of way, yeah. we as committee members yeah. will even help out to, right. you know, to collect information from the person mm-hmm. and bring it into the office. And I think that's key too, because yeah. there are so many seniors who know more information than mm-hmm. even mm-hmm. our generation. And many seniors have been unfortunately passed over because of a lack of information mm-hmm. or a lack of interest. Yes. And this is just to show you that last year, I was at the Southampton Princess mm-hmm. and having dinner with one of my friends, and this gentleman was sitting there watching the television. Unbeknownst to me, he has a plethora of information into North Village. Mm-hmm. Apparently has started North Village or was instrumental in the, you know, organization of North Village. And I had no idea.
Right.
And so I said to his family, listen, you know, this is information that's vital, and it's very great that we could talk about the sports awards, deliberations, make sure when it comes around, you submit your information. So I hope that they hear me tonight mm-hmm. talking about them. I right. can't exactly remember the gentleman's name,
right.
but if I see him, I will know him. And we all had a great conversation. Mm-hmm. So I am really hoping that the family takes that initiative.
Right.
And to recognize their family member, because sometimes we wait around for everybody else.
Yeah, that's right.
And you should really take care of your own. Mm-hmm. So, yes, mm-hmm. I encourage them to do that.
Mr. Simons, can you give us the breakdown of the other awards, such as the sports citation?
I love that area, because I think that's where I got my award.
Yeah, go ahead and give it, Deborah.
Yeah, sports citation.
Yes.
It is presented to those individuals, governing bodies, teams, and clubs who have distinguished themselves in sport both past and present. So here we are talking about prior years.
Right.
And this is a good example of where we don't look at just the present, but the past contributions.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Which
yes.
Which is very important.
Very important. And
we have
five.
To remember, yeah, we have to remember those who have come before.
Oh, definitely.
And laid that foundation mm-hmm. for others to come through and be a part of what we are today.
Exactly. Yeah. Five recipients received those awards.
Five, yeah. Mm-hmm. Appreciation awards, Mr. Sun?
Yeah. This is the award that is presented to sports bodies, organizations, local and international companies who conduct international amateur games at all levels in Bermuda. An appropriate award will be presented to the organizing committee of the event. It may also be presented to clubs or organizations, local and international companies who have pioneered, organized, and implemented a community parish program aimed at family youth sports development or participation. There's five recipients, a maximum of five recipients mm-hmm. may receive such an award in any year.
Let me just ask a question.
Mm-hmm.
I already know the answer, but I think us discussing, we also at the table can put in what was considered a special award.
Special recognition
yes.
award.
Mm-hmm.
And that's for people who don't quite meet or go beyond what these... Mm-hmm. These are?
Yeah, and also it 9 times 10 it can be someone who did a really outstanding performance but did not warrant them to be an athlete of the year mm-hmm. or an achievement award or for can organize a one-off event, say for instance in the course of the year. It's at the discretion of the committee
mm-hmm.
To determine if this warrants a special recognition. And the committee will sit on and debate that. So, you know.
We have done it in the past.
Yes, yes we've given
so,
out. Yes.
You know, we definitely are mm-hmm. all about the business and given the recognition yeah. that is due.
Over the years, we've been involved in the sports awards and seen many different sporting bodies acknowledged at the awards night and many different faces.
Mm-hmm.
Not what one would consider a regular sport. You've mm-hmm. seen the sport of softball. You've seen tennis. Mm-hmm. You've seen sailing, and you've seen the door open and the door close on mm-hmm. many of sports.
Mm-hmm.
What are you hoping, or where are we hoping that this can go as far as being avid sports people, outside of the fact that we deliberate on this stuff, me personally, I would like to see all of Bermuda sports involved in nominating their people and making sure that they recognize their athletes. I say it all the time. Every year, national sports governing bodies have an award ceremony of their own, and they pick a male. If it's a dual sport, mm-hmm. they pick a male and a female athlete right. of the year. Mm-hmm. But we don't see it when it comes down to this type of stuff. And that's where I think frustrates me the most, is that the sports need to recognize their athletes outside of their sport, not just we're going to have a ceremony and we're just going to put down that Debbie Jones Thompson's mm-hmm. female athlete,
yes.
Norbert Simons is the male athlete, and mm-hmm. be done with it. You can't be done with it. You have to let the island know.
Well, it's a trust factor. I think that national sports governing bodies have got to learn to trust the process
mm-hmm.
more than anything else. I think that sometimes some people just assume that, oh, they just did something locally, they shouldn't be nominated. My frustration is that we have these events, and not just this event, and you know, sometimes it's not as supported as well as it should be.
Mm-hmm.
I know we're talking about the sports awards tonight, even our junior sponsorship award. There are 37 to 38 national sports governing bodies. And even when we do a junior sponsorship, we want to highlight the accomplishments of at least one junior athlete and support them financially. It's usually just about 14 or 15 national sports governing bodies that take advantage of it. And then they'll cry wolf and say that the process is not fair. Or they'll say that we're wasting our money on supporting same old athletes, but that's not the fault of the department. We send these invitations out to mm-hmm. everybody, to all national sports government. That's the first source. Because let me say this here. Anytime you receive, and you saw the banner earlier, anytime you receive any nomination for any sport, the first persons we check is the national sports governing body to ensure that person is in good standing.
Mm-hmm.
If they're not in good standing, their application on the word of the national sports governing body is withdrawn. And we've had that in the past. The public has cried out, why didn't so-and-so get a nomination or an award? But it's not our place to go back and say that they were not in good standing, because we have to trust the word of the national sports governing body, mm-hmm. and in turn, the national sports governing body has to have trust in us as well.
Mm-hmm. I think that my disappointment comes, like you said, when the national sports governing bodies don't send in a nomination
mm-hmm.
of an athlete, because everyone's contribution is important, no matter how small or how large.
That's
and
right.
You don't have to be an elite athlete to say that, you know, hey,
I accomplished something.
Yeah. The time you put in, the commitment, all of that is very paramount.
Mm-hmm.
And I think mm-hmm. also, too, is that, as Director Simon said, the country is not going to know about you unless the nomination comes in.
Mm-hmm.
And we always say, do you know about so-and-so? Do you remember? I don't have a clue. Well, this is a point of education.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, and we have to start taking pride in our country, in our sport, and let's put a good effort forward. And just the same as those NSGBs may have their own prize givings, it's not where it's open to the media
mm-hmm.
and everyone mm-hmm. is aware.
Right.
You know, social media, what have you. And however we can reach our public, that's what we're going to do.
Well, I honestly believe the Sports Awards is a night to celebrate sports in Bermuda, and that means all sports in Bermuda.
Exactly.
And if NSGB, National Sports Governing Body, decides not to celebrate their athletes amongst the island, I think they're doing a disservice to their athletes.
And to the program, personally, if you ask my opinion.
Yeah.
And I hear all the time that people talk about we must be proud of Bermudians. I said, well, the only time we're going to be proud of Bermudians is that we have to stand up and say we're proud of Bermudians.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Let's put Bermuda first. I mean, you know, when I hear that our kids can name off the starting 11 for Liverpool,
mm-hmm.
why can't tell me who plays for some as a cricket club?
Yeah.
You know, so we're really a surprise. I mean,
why
we talk about being proud to be Bermudian, and quite frankly, I know I'm going to be controversial. The only time you start talking about being proud to be Bermudian is when you want to be the Bermudian of the year, then it's political.
Mm.
Otherwise, in that, you're just not good enough. in any respect, and that's a frustrating part for me. And I've been director for a little while, and that's one of the frustrating parts for me, is that when I hear people talking about, oh, why should we support this and why should we support that? You come out and watch Corrupted because you want to see Jamaica beat the piss out of us. Excuse my language. Mm-hmm. Right? Or you want to come out and, you know, our national team, you only want to come up and you think they're going to be in.
Yes, come and support
No matter what. Because
we all started at one point. Yeah. I myself didn't start as a winner.
Yeah.
But I kept at it, you know? And I agree with you, Director Simon, said, you know, we have to learn to be supportive no matter
what.
Because we are Bermudian.
And you know, because I look at, because I can look at international events. You know, I mean, the problem that I have in Bermuda is that they only want to support you when you're winning.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Well, hell, when you're winning, the world supports you. It's getting to that point. It's when people are done in the dumps and those athletes are, we don't want to accept the fact that we have a lot of our kids who are out there training in the rain, the wind, and whatever, in all conditions that are foreign to other athletes, and then we criticize them because they didn't do as well. But we don't want to support them financially. We don't want to support them emotionally. I mean, there's no better feeling than looking up in the stands and seeing that the stands are full. You know what that does to an athlete?
Mm-hmm.
You know? I look at Corrupted. When we walked in the stage in 2012, the stands were full. I know what it did for me, and I was standing up and ushering people on the field. Exactly. And I watched the chests of our kids blow up because everybody was out there supporting them.
Sense of pride.
And you know, we need to understand that pride comes not only when you're winning, but that pride is needed even more to get you to that place. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to.
And I think that the reason why Director Simons is so passionate, so am I, is because we have been there ourselves, and we know what support does. And if you look at the Olympics, look at the resilience. You know, there were when their natives came out to participate, and no matter what position, I mean, the support,
it's important.
You know, the accolade, the clapping, the cheering was very, very paramount, and it was just, you know, it was a bit heart-wrenching, you know, and because to see that there was that pride, and I think for us, we, as Bermudians, our sports, you know, unfortunately has somewhat declined, but support makes a difference.
Oh, yeah.
And so, you know, and we keep talking about this, and we're going to always talk about it, because that, and if we don't communicate our passion,
our sports has declined, let's be quite frank, our sports has declined because of the criticism that our athletes receive.
Mm-hmm.
Who wants to go out there and face that criticism every day and not being appreciated for the hard work that they do?
And it is hard.
You know,
the commitment, the sacrifice.
Without a doubt.
Yeah.
You know, let's face it. I mean, you know, look, Clyde Best. I'm using it as an example, right?
Mm-hmm.
We run this man down to the ground in Bermuda. I bet you his book sales are doing better in England than they are in this country.
Well, you know, so funny that you mentioned Clyde Bass. When Mr. Holder and I, on behalf of Posada, went to the symposium, we stopped into UCAT Anti-Doping Organization.
Mm-hmm.
And so this gentleman, he had to be no more than about, I guess, about 32. And this was about 3 years ago. And he said, oh, you're from Bermuda. And we said, yes. And then he said, do you know Clyde Bass? And we said, yeah, you know, we know Clyde Bass. Right. And he says, oh my goodness, I have all of these videotapes of Clyde Bass playing. And so Lee Holder said, Hunter, let's call Clyde. So unbeknownst to the young man, we called Clyde and we passed the phone to him. He was overjoyed.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he... Oh my goodness. We were so shocked because, you know, to this day, it is something to remember. And so then Lee ended up getting a hat autographed by Clyde, and we sent it to him.
Right.
He was only like 30, 32.
I'm trying to tell you.
So You know what I mean? The love, respect, the
passion. Outside of the country.
Yeah, outside of the country.
And so we're now trying to keep, we keep pushing this transfer. I'm always going to push this transfer here in Birmingham.
Right.
You know, something's going to give.
I mean, because, come on, man. This little small little country produced world champions. Mm-hmm. Okay? I know we're making a lot of noise about Flora Duffy, and she deserves every accolade and kudos that she has.
Yeah, she did. Excellent.
But we have Brian Melman, who we've just pushed to the side like he doesn't exist. All right? We have Troy Douglas, who was a silver medalist at a world meet, World Indoor Championships. We have Nikki Saunders, who still holds the Commonwealth record.
She sure does.
In high jump. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Since 1980, correct me if I'm wrong.
That's correct.
This is 2016?
This is 2016.
And he still holds that record for 36 years.
26, and do you know how hard it is to hold records that long in international competition?
Yeah, exactly.
Especially with the advancement of training and the advancement of, you know,
doping.
And you know that hurts my heart when you talk about the advancement of doping.
But it is.
But it's you're right, nobody, it is reality. But
even in track and field, how many of our kids know of the accomplishments of a Brian Wellman or a Troy Douglas? Mm-hmm. When they walk in, you say, Yahoo? Who? Never heard of you. Because we have not done a good job in this country of celebrating our accomplishments. Mm-hmm. We do a great job of criticizing when you fall down.
Mm-hmm.
Ask Clarence Hill, because you've never forgiven him for whatever you think indiscretions has done in his life.
And then, you know, and we really have to take a look at ourselves and simply say, you know, that it's we need to do better. Let's do better all the time.
Right.
In every respect in this country, because not only in sports have we done extremely well, we've done it well in businesses, we've done all these things, but you're so quick to bring in somebody else because they have a different accent and celebrate their accomplishments.
Mm-hmm. Well, I am thinking to myself that we are going to do better. I know we are.
Mm-hmm.
I am always going to be, even if I get to be 99 and still living in my great island.
That's my dream too, Deborah.
You know, we always, and so while we talk passionately about all of this, it's a serious
very
matter.
Serious.
It's a serious
Mr.
matter.
Mr. Simons brought up something a few minutes ago that, you know, congratulations to Flora Duffy, and she deserves all the accolades.
Oh, did she ever?
She deserves more than what we've been given her so far.
8 years ago, she was getting hammered.
Yes.
Hammered.
And stared to the wicket.
Right.
Exactly.
Support.
Yeah.
You know, you got to give her credit.
Because
and
all
right.
these
Look
people that are now jumping up and congratulating were some of the
same people that criticized
her. Quit. You're no good.
Yes.
Get out.
Exactly.
Because I don't forget those things.
But you see, perseverance makes a difference. That's the heart of a champion.
Yeah.
And we also have to remember that no matter what people say around us, what do you want for yourself?
Yeah,
that's right.
What do you want
for
to advance in your sport?
And you know what? I'm going to
so
say this, right?
Hang in there, athletes. Hang in there.
And you know what I'm going to say? For me, Flora's accomplishment rings volumes for women in sport in this country.
Yes, it does.
Because every sport, and we've had some really outstandingly talented young ladies that could have gone further than the males in sport in this country.
Mm-hmm.
But for whatever reason, pressure's played on them that shouldn't be. And for whatever reason, at 15, 16 years old, we start losing them out of sport.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen some women in my short time in track and field in the last 5-6 years who should have been world beaters, who had the ability to be world beaters, but where are they?
I agree, Norman.
Where are they?
Sure,
we have not done enough to captivate and embrace our women in sport. The other thing that we've done is, whether we want to like it or not, we have looked at our males in sport, and instead of embracing them and looking at the work that they do, we're castigating them. And then we wonder why they don't want to represent the country. Then we wonder why people are leaving these shores, because they don't feel like the value they're doing in the country. I go back to a thing that Clive Lone used to say to us, God rest his dead ashes, when he used to say, a man can never be king of castle of his own rock. He has to go somewhere else to be king. You know what that translates to? If you want to be respected,
you need to go
somewhere else to be respected, and then they may come back and embrace you. I don't know.
Well, it hasn't happened to the Circle I.
Well, it's Bob, yeah, Bob.
And many others, many others that have gone down that road.
They, I'm a civil servant. I can't speak out.
But she just gave you the exact sample of.
Yeah. And I saw it for myself.
Yeah, if I could walk anywhere in England,
look what she would go to.
Yeah, yeah. How like on the
look at these guys. Anywhere.
Yeah,
we
are. And we're all singing the same song and delivering the message in different ways. And at the end of the day, the support, in my opinion, needs to be enhanced. I will never say that we don't have any. Mm-hmm. We need
needs to be enhanced.
More importantly,
the question needs to be asked, why is it that we don't want to celebrate Bermudian success at any level?
I can answer that with ease. And it's we want to make sure we keep each other down.
Well, you know, I always look at I'm more of a glass half full than half empty person. Mm-hmm. And I keep pushing the same matches, and I keep having this hope and that it's going to be so different one day. But I think that we, as a country, we have to learn how to love our athletes. We
not
don't,
just our athletes,
you know,
ourselves.
I mean, even yes, but I mean, we're talking like in this sports
arena
here
room, yes.
that we have to learn to love our athletes. All of our athletes in this island are great. Because you don't win a gold medal, that doesn't make you great, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people win gold medals and don't get there in a great and honorable and with integrity.
Right.
So
that
exactly,
yes.
And so, you know, you can't always value someone based on a medal. You know, it's they give their heart. Yes, it is their choice,
mm-hmm.
but they give their heart to this island.
Mm-hmm.
When you go out there and train every day, you are giving your heart to this island to say, "I am going to do the best I can, no matter what."
Mm-hmm. Sure. And my goal is to reach the top.
Yeah, and your top doesn't have to be a gold medal.
Mm-hmm.
Your top could be representing your country in a distinguished manner, respectful manner, putting Bermuda on the map.
And we've done that.
Yeah, but putting Bermuda on the map goes a long way, and is done in many different ways.
Right.
You know, so I always say, you know, to people, listen, stay focused,
right.
You know, but, and it was easier said than done.
Yes.
And, you know, but that's how I have always.
But getting back to the sports awards, that's just one way for NSGBs to recognize or get recognition of their athletes for the country to know.
Yes, because a lot of people don't know
athletes
that are competing in various sports.
Right,
and so NSGBs, take responsibility. Mm-hmm. Take responsibility. And do the right thing. Take the time. Put the time
and
in.
And poke your head out of the sand.
Yeah, and you know what? The same information that you all are delivering over on when you have your awards, just send that information on to.
Yeah,
it's already done.
Yes, amen. It is already
done. You just have to take it from your paper and put it on another piece of paper, and away you go.
And I think also too, it shows the athlete in that particular sport that you know what, my governing my governing body cares about me, and I am worth the time to send an application in. It doesn't take a long time or much work.
They appreciate my hard work.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, and appreciate.
And that's all some of our athletes want.
That's all anybody wants to be appreciated.
Just acknowledgement of somebody appreciates what I'm attempting to do.
And you know, we are here begging for NSGBs to send in because we see it all year after year after year. And you know, you never want to hurt your athlete's heart by ignoring them.
Right.
Come on.
Right.
Let's get it together. Yeah. Let's get on board.
I would hate to see an athlete walk up to their president of their NSGB and say, "Was I nominated?" And the person has to tell them.
Maybe they should. Maybe that's what they should do is ask. Put them on the spot.
Well,
why
maybe
not?
They are asking, man. You know what it is? But see, this is what we do. Another thing we do well in this country is deflect.
Well, at the end of the day, you still have to say no.
Yeah.
And then, really, why don't you incorporate the athlete? Hey, athletes, call the Department of Youth Sport and Recreation. Mm. You know, check on your list. Have I been nominated? Mm. You know?
Well, nine times out of ten, you know, as a confidentiality thing, that we normally don't tell people who nominated them.
No, but that they are nominated. Because we don't have the television show anymore, correct?
Yeah, but I mean, but the fact that we may say that I can't tell you who nominated you, but there's nothing stopping you from making a petty request.
No, but what I'm saying is that if an athlete was, if they have been nominated, yeah, you're not disclosing who the person is, but at least you're saying.
I mean, in the past, we wouldn't normally say if they were nominated or not, because again, we were protecting our national sports governing bodies. We were trying to show, you know, be nominated, because I know that some people knew that some male athletes of the year, female athletes of the year, have been nominated by the public, not by the national sports governing bodies.
And we've seen that,
And I think we have to be honest about that.
Yeah, we have to be honest about that. And that's why I've been crying.
It does need to be said, because truth and honesty is what it is.
Yes.
And so very true.
Yeah, you know.
So very true.
Mm-hmm. You know, but we wouldn't make it
a
habit to.
Even in other areas, it's not just the male and female. Even in the sports citation, you know. So, and one thing I do want to say is that we must say that with the Appreciation Award, the organizations that provide funds so that an event can operate effectively.
Is important to acknowledge.
It's very important.
Very important to acknowledge.
And so, you know, hats off to them, you know.
And the administrators of sport need to be acknowledged. They have to be acknowledged.
Indeed, Norbert.
Because they're the ones that, frankly, that's okay.
Excuse me, pardon me, yes.
I was named Norbert before director. Another name, Norbert. But, you know, I say that because a lot of times, you know, there are a lot of administrators out there. I know we're harping about the lack of support we get from national sports governing bodies. But there are a lot of administrators out there, coaches, parents who go above and beyond the call of duty, who never get recognized, but they get criticized when things don't go right. I mean, if you're out there sometimes like 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning, you see them out there marking out courses.
It's hard work, you know.
It's hard work. You see them out there when everything is over and said and done. The athletes have gone home and the parents have left.
They're cleaning up.
Still there cleaning up way after everybody else. Mm-hmm. And they're still doing it, you know. And you know what? You know, they need to be celebrated, because you know what? They're out there doing it. And during the event, this is not done right. That's not done right.
But look what a great example they are setting for others.
Exactly.
That they're showing passion support.
Yeah.
Supporting their children and supporting other children whose parents may not be able to attend because they're working or they're not well or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But it takes a village. It's the same it's the same thing. It's that slogan will just resonate, I think, for the rest of our lives and continue on.
Right,
And so with the organizations and the parental involvement and not always parents. There are a lot of people who don't have children in the sport but dedicate themselves.
Or their children have gone on, they still stay to help.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's interesting that we're going to be deliberating in an Olympic year, because usually that's kind of a year that it's a lot of juices flowing. It's a lot of excitement. So we'll have to see who's put forward, and hopefully we get this mouth-watering information put down that some of us may have missed, and you know.
Yeah. Well, how many national sports governing bodies do we have, Director Simons?
38.
So I am looking forward to receiving 38 nominations.
Could be double in some sports.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's fine. I'm just looking for, about male and then 38 female.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Give my women the share.
I'm going to do the catamosi pigeon. I mean.
Why not?
We this year may be a year, who knows, that we may have a junior male athlete of the year repeat as a male athlete of the year.
You just never know.
Or junior female athlete of the year could be the year.
Yeah.
I mean, you never know. I mean, you know, let's face it. I mean,
there have been
some outstanding performances by junior athletes.
Yeah.
I must say, I am really excited the fact that the junior male and female athlete of the year has been added to the forum, because we have to acknowledge them from a younger age so that they feel as if there's something to grow to and not just feel as if they're overlooked because of their age.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad the community agreed to do that a few years ago.
Exactly. Yeah. That was a great move.
Yes.
Yeah, UMA's is just as good as the 38 nominations again. I feel it.
That
might open the back. I do feel it, yes. Catch yourself with a bad director. And I'm looking forward to when we meet and chat, because believe it or not, we all grow and learn so much at this table.
Yes. Yeah.
And that's what I also
like. And I must say, as much as I get out and see different sports, it's around this table and reading information that I grow even more.
Yeah.
Because you get to see some of the things that you've missed or you might even overlook.
And it also for us to also to continue to understand when sports are growing.
Yeah.
And that's why I look forward to hearing from you, Earl. You know, we have two women on our committee, Brenda Dale and myself.
Right.
And we hang in with you guys, and I really love the camaraderie.
I'd like to think that we hang in with you, you know.
Do you think so? Well, now that could be a good point too.
And I say that because we all have our strengths, we all have our weaknesses, but you know what? What I really like about the deliberation part is that everybody has input. And I'm prepared. And I'm prepared to state their case before we even go to vote, because what people need to know that sometimes, man, even though this bond is a small bond.
Yes.
Okay?
Yeah,
we've had bonds twice this size.
Sure have.
And I thought that last year, in the last debate, that we'd have been finished by 10:30. We didn't finish till almost 1 o'clock.
Yeah,
we talked about
About everything. We even made regulations. Because I want people to know that we look at the rules and regulations and look to update them and improve on them every year. Hence the reason why the male athlete, junior male and female athlete came into play. And then a few years later, it was only right that we brought in the achievement award for the junior athletes.
Exactly.
So, you know, it's always a work in progress. We're always looking to try to improve. We listen to, what comments come in from, because we do a postmortem. We do, after sports awards, we listen to the comments that the public makes. I know that, we've also been asked on numerous occasions to downsize the program. And I will say, I've resisted it as a director. I've resisted it because, as far as I'm concerned, this is the most prestigious sporting event, and it needs to be treated in such a way. I'm not going to have it in somebody's hole. I knew that we're having at the Sunhampton Princess, because right now Sunhampton Princess is the one that can do, you know, is the best hotel for it right now. If another hotel or another venue comes along that's better than Sunhampton Princess, then we will take it there. When I retire, you can do what you like. But on my watch,
a celebrated event.
It has to be.
We need to put it in its right perspective.
Exactly,
yes,
it is.
We do.
You know,
we do.
We have to, because this is. We have to highlight the accomplishment, because we have to admit that, understand that 99% of our athletes are amateurs.
Yes, they are.
Who are sacrificing their time? Their parents are paying for it out of their pocket. Most of the coaches that are involved are volunteers. When I say volunteers, who not only give up time, they give up money, they give up a lot of things to ensure that these athletes achieve their goals. And I think that they are the unsung heroes, who are the ones that have to put up the shields because darts are thrown at them. And people will say, why did you do it this way and why did you do it that way? I know when I used to coach, I said, well, you know what? Come out and help me. I ain't got time for them rude little boys.
Could be saying, well, you know, this is what they choose to do, but true said, but also too, is that this is their contribution to the betterment of our country. In sport, other ones do it in education.
It's all valuable.
So to me, what I would really, really like to see is that we show up at sporting events, various sporting national championships, you know, celebrate the athletes, learn about the sport. You know, maybe you don't have to give up yourself, but you can give up something else, maybe financial, or you may know someone else and networking and all that. Let's grow our country. Come on, Bermuda. Exactly.
And quite frankly, you know, in the sporting arena, you really get to see what people are really like, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Some of these same children that you write off, Are some of the most intelligent, talented people that you ever come across. And that's the satisfaction that I get out of coaching, just to watch them grow. Watch them grow.
You know, and be instrumental in the construction of their lives. Moving forward, it's a lot more than just out there just training.
It's a life lesson.
It is. And it can give you a lot of great hope and prosperity in the future.
Yeah.
For me, sport has been, the best thing that happened.
For a lot of us, because I'm going to tell you I say it all the time, I could have been a gangster,
I'm going to tell you,
But you know that too, Deborah. Deborah, you know that, don't lie.
Yes, but you always put the different elevated talk to the track team. And so, we knew all where we stood, but Norbert was honest, Gunn was honest, Clive was honest. That's what I think for us as we developed, through our youth and then as adults. And that's why we talk like, how we are and passionate. Sometimes, we may get, I never say we're never too passionate. We're just really straightforward. And it may come across as a bit abrasive, but
get over it.
We know what we're talking about. We've been there.
Right.
So, and we can see the difference between now and then. And there are too many all of us in these positions that have been sportsmen and act like we haven't. Come on, Bermuda, let's get it together. Right. Let's get it together.
Well, very good talk.
I'm always excited to talk about
sports. Can't wait to see these nomination forms come in.
We'll have a job after this.
I can't wait because I'm expecting to see that I'm going to have a bind of this and maybe these two.
Let's hope.
Maybe the large body won't be big enough.
But remember, we give the committee members these bonds 2 weeks in advance.
And so, we read them and we come prepared. So I'm looking forward to the sports awards. God willing, I'll be here March 30th.
But the most important day for us is January.
The date hasn't been set yet.
Okay.
We try to do it because depending on how much information you have, we normally try to have the meeting by the third week in January.
Right.
You should come up. We should for the third Saturday in January because it gives us 3 weeks to research the information to ensure that everybody on the list, especially those for the individual awards like Male and Female Athlete of the Year and the Achievement Awards, are Bermudian.
Mm-hmm.
Let me quote again, Bermudian.
That's important. And I just hope that, I'm encouraging all to reach out if you need help, assistance, reach out. Reach out and touch. Not a Ross said.
That's right.
You know what I mean? And we can only get better
if
we reach out and touch and take care of business.
There you go. So you heard it from Debbie Jones Hunter, Director Norbert Simons, Amaro Basten. Do enjoy the rest of your night.